Hello there, this is Dave Allen, and today we're having a look at Alfred and see what we can do with some of the basics of it. And there's a thing that I found out called the buffer, which is really quite nice. So what we can do is we can open up Alfred, and as you can see, I've got three files in there that are in the buffer. So let's just get rid of those first of all and see how we get them in there. So option key and left arrow takes things out of the buffer. But how do we put stuff into the buffer? Okay, so let's have a look and do a search. So go for some images. So you can press the shift key and you can have a look and see what's in those files there. But what we want to do is we want to take a couple of these pictures and we want to do something with them. So what we're going to do this time is we're going to press the option key and the up arrow. And that selected one of them. And we'll select this one here. And we'll go down here and we'll select this one here. So now I've got three files in the buffer. Now what I'll do is press the option key and the right arrow. And now I can do some various things with it. So I can open them with a particular application. Press enter. So now I've got a choice and I can put it in whichever application I want to use there. Escape out of that. And the files are still there in the buffer. Let's do the option and right arrow again. So now I can send these off as an email to somebody. So all I have to do is to put in the name of the person I want to email them to. I'm going to email them to myself. So there you go. That's how you can use Alfred to start an email with a number of different files being attached to it. If you could help me out by going to the share button and sharing out to one of the places, you could share it out to Facebook, for instance. Just click on a button there and something comes up. And if you want to share it to more places, just click on that there and you've got a few different choices there. You can even share it out to Pinterest. Don't forget to click on the like button. Thanks a lot. And as you can see from the settings for the buffer, I've got it set so that it is enabled. That's the thing to start with. You've got a few details about how to use that. So if you do option up arrow, adds a file. If you do option down arrow, add a file and move to the next selection. So if you use option and the left arrow, it removes the last item from the buffer, and option right arrow will action all items in the buffer. So you can see that I've got the two checkboxes ticked there with the clear after actioning items in the buffer. So once you've done the thing with them, you don't need to do it again. And also clear the buffer if not used for 5 minutes. So let's just go into the Finder and see what else we could do with this here. So with using shift and the right arrow, I get straight to the action menu of Alfred. I can do various things with various files. So I've got one file selected there, but what if I've got three files selected? Shift and right arrow. I've got three files selected, and now I have a choice of several different things that I can do with those files. And there you go, isn't that marvellous? Dealing with a few files in Alfred. Thanks for watching the video, and why don't you check out the other videos? Here's two of them. There's one video there and one video there that you can click on and go and have a look at now. And don't forget that you can also subscribe. Talk to you again soon. Bye bye now.